If you're using Redis in your Spring application without making use of Redis OM, then you're missing out on something. Redis OM stands for Redis Object Mapping and is a library built on top of Spring Data Redis. It provides high-level APIs to model and access your data using the full features of RedisSearch and RedisJSON. In this video, I'm showing how to integrate Redis OM in your Spring application and easily get started. So, in order to do that, I've created a new Spring Boot project. The first thing to do after creating a project is to add the dependency to the POM file. So here is my POM file, and I've added the dependency for Redis OM. And the current version at the time of recording of this video is 0.87, right? So after doing that, we need now to understand how do we model our object, right? For example, let's say we want to save company information in Redis. Let's say we have an application that saves company information. I want to save the company information in Redis. We will create. So yeah, I've created a package called Redis, probably because in our application, we may have a package for Redis and we have another package for where we save data in our database, be it MySQL or PostgreSQL. So I created a package here for Redis. And now I created another package called model. In this model, this is where I will create the classes that describes the structure of the data I'm trying to save in Redis. For example, for company, I have this, where I have this class models the information I want to keep about the company. So this will be the ID of the company, right? This is the name, the URL, the geolocation, position of the company, the tax, the number of employees, the year it was founded, and if it's publicly listed in a public exchange market or not, right? So one thing that's very important about Redis OM is that when you want to model your data, you need to describe it as document. So this is annotation that describes it as a document. So by so doing, our data will be saved as a JSON document in Redis. So that's why we use the document annotation. And now we need to annotate our ID with the ID field, this field right here. And now the name, we annotated the name with searchable. Searchable, why? Because we want to be able to search a company by its name, right? And bear in mind that companies can have similar names. For example, we have MTN Cameroon and we have MTN Nigeria. These are two different companies, even though it belongs to the same group, but these are two different companies and both of them contain the name MTN, right? So we put this as searchable so that we can implement a full text search on this name field. That's why we gave it searchable. Also added index on the location because we want to be able to search a company by its location. So when we use an index on a particular object or data type, right, we want to be able to search with this specific data type. For example, we put index on the number of employees. We want to be able to search that companies with this specific number of employees. That's why we put an index right here. We also put an index on the tax. The tax, for example, can be like properties describing a company. For example, IT, telecom, manufacturing, you know. So if you want to be able to search a company by a tag, we also need to have an index annotation for tags, right? That is it. So this shows how we were able to model our company, right? The thing to do after defining our company structure this way, that is after defining our company class, defining its properties, now we need to define a repository. Now I created a repository package and created a class called company repo, which extends Redis document repository. It extends the Redis document repository because our company has been defined as a document by using the annotation document, as you can see right here, right? So we define our company repository as a Redis document repository, and we use string here because the ID of our document has been defined with data type string. So we have to use string right here, right? So now let's say, for example, we want to query our Redis database with a name. Let's say we want to find out what are the companies where the name contain a particular text. So we use this find all by name, and we pass in the argument we're looking for, right? So we can add other methods. For example, let's say we want to find companies. Let's say find all by employee, right? Let's say find all by employee count. This is a number of employees, right? Let's say find all by number of employees. We'll go back to repository. Say find all by number of employees, and here we pass in this. So this method will give us the possibility to search for companies having a specific number of employees. So the argument we'll pass here, we're going to search. Let's say we want to find out companies having 100 employees. We'll call this method on our repository and pass the number 100. Now, after defining your repository, what you need to do next is to enable the Redis repositories, right? We need to do that by coming in our main class and adding enable Redis document repositories. You have to understand that our model was defined as a document. Our repository was defined as a Redis document repository. So we need to enable this Redis document repository. To do that, we use this annotation enable Redis document repositories with base package, this specific package right here. We specify this package because this is the package. And the model and the repository are contained in this package called Redis. So that's why we define as base package this package right here. Now, that is all we need to do to be able to add Redis OM to your application. In order to test this, we need to go to our properties file and define the port of Redis. Let's say Spring Data Redis, the port. I'll be running Redis on port 6, the normal port for 6379. And one thing I want to emphasize here is that, look, one thing I want to emphasize here is that the Spring Data Redis, the database by default is 0, right? Redis search will not work if you use something else for the Spring Data Redis database, right? So this should be 0. If you plan to use Redis search, this value should always be 0. So if you try to change this value to something else, it will not work. Redis search will not work in your configuration. So either you allow it to be with 0, or you just remove it completely because the default value for this property is 0. Right there. So for me, I'll just allow it, and I will give my application a name. Let's say Redis OM. Right, since we're testing Redis OM, and if you're using something different from your host, you can override this property and put in the address of your host. So by default it's localhost, and by default this port is 6379. Now let me go on and start my Docker container for Redis. So here I'm starting my Docker container for Redis, and the container is started. So that is it. I've started the container. Now I need to populate my Redis instance, because if I go to Redis Insight right here, you find out that it's empty. You find out that my Redis Insight is quite empty. There's nothing in my Redis setup. There's no data. So what I need to do right now is to populate my Redis database. And in order to do that, I will create a command line runner, right? Let's say load data, and I will say this is my bin, right? Load data, and let's say this returns something like this. Right now, I will import my Redis repository using the auto-wired annotation company repo. Right now, let's say I want to delete everything in my Redis data source. Now I need now to create a sample company information. So I'll just rapidly create one of them, and probably fast forward the video to create the others, right? So let me create a sample one. Let's say for example this is MTN Cameroon I'm creating for, right? And MTN Cameroon has address as mtn.cm, and the geolocation of MTN Cameroon, let's say I'll just put something, anything, because I don't have the exact data. It's just for demonstration purposes. Okay. So the next information required is the number of employees. Let's say it has 1,000 employees, right? And let's say it was founded in 1980, for example. So I've created a company. Let's name this MTN Cameroon, right? So this is a sample information. This is sample company that will be saved in Redis. And I will just fast forward the video in order to create many more companies, so that we will have enough data to be able to and to properly analyze what we want to do. So I'll just fast forward the video. Okay, these are the companies I've created: MTN Cameroon, MTN Nigeria, MTN Redis, Microsoft, right? And I've added attacks to these various companies. Now I can use a company.saveAll, and this will save our company information into Redis. So if I run this application right now and go back to Redis Insight, I should be able to see this data saved in Redis Insight, right? So let us run our application and find out what's happening. Our application is running, and you can find out that Spring was able to detect one document, like that is our document, our company document, and it went on to create the indexes, right? As the index that was defined in our document were created. So that's why he found a searchable, he found an index. So he found our different indexes that were defined in our document, and he went on to create them. So if I go now to our Redis Insight, I should be able to see, if I refresh here, I should be able to see the data that was created exactly. This is our data. As you can see right here, this is our company Microsoft. This is our company Redis. This is another company MTN Nigeria. And this is our company MTN Cameroon. So you can find out that our data were properly inserted in our Redis database. Now, how do we retrieve this data? Let's find out how do we retrieve this data. We can test, for example, let's say we want to find out what are all the companies, want to find out from our repository what are all the companies having the name MTN, for example. So I will rerun our program in debug mode in order to see the result of this query. So let me run our program in debug mode again. Oh, okay. So if I highlight this line and say evaluate expression, normally we have MTN Cameroon and we have MTN Nigeria. And if that field was defined as searchable means that a full text search can be applied on that field. So if I search by this, I'm expecting to have two results, right? I'm expecting my result to have two items, MTN Cameroon and MTN Nigeria. Exactly. So this is it. As you can see right here, our result has two items, MTN Cameroon and MTN Nigeria, because the word MTN is found in the name of both companies. So you can have that. And if I say I just search with MTN Cameroon, for example, you'll find out that the result will just be a single item. Yes, is it. Just MTN Cameroon, because I'm searching with the full name MTN Cameroon. So this is an example of what you can do with Redis OM. I'm sure you can do much more with Redis OM. I'm inviting you to check out the link for Redis OM in the description below. And this was just an introductory video to show you how to integrate and how to use Redis OM in your Spring application. In the next video, I will show you how to do complex queries and how to properly model your data in Redis in order to take full advantage of the features available in RedisSearch and RedisJSON. Thank you for watching, and let me know what you think about this video, and drop down your comments in the comment section below, and share with those you think it may be useful to them, and see you in the next video. Thank you.